We're on a really exciting journey with Windows 8. For developers in particular, 8.1 is a great release. Hi, I'm Antoine Leblond. I'm Vice President of Program Management on the Windows team. So we're really excited to actually have this new release of Windows for you. Windows 8 was about a lot of new things, and Windows 8.1 is really about building on what we started with Windows 8, and really about listening and refining what we did and improving the product and continuing to actually make progress towards our vision. One of the things that we're really excited about actually in 8.1 is all the new windowing work that we've done. So as developers, you probably know that there's a lot of great stuff you can do if you can have multiple apps up on the screen. In Windows 8, we had this thing that we called Snap View, which was great for a certain type of application that would actually be great in a really narrow window on the left while we're using the majority of the screen for something else. We've created a much more flexible model now for actually having multiple apps on the screen where you have a slider that you can adjust anywhere you want so that you can really adjust your windows exactly as you want them. One of the things that we know that people are really doing with Windows 8 is customizing their start screen a lot. And one of the things that they really have been asking us for, or would love, is more flexibility and more control over the size of tiles. So we've introduced two new tile sizes, a really large one that's bigger than any of the tiles we had before, and a much smaller one, which lets you pack a lot of information on your start screen. The big ones in particular are really interesting to developers because they give you a lot of surface area to actually do things like provide, you know, live updates. For example, a calendaring app, instead of showing you maybe just your next appointment, has room now to show your next three appointments. A lot of apps would love to have a search control right there inside the app instead of having it in the charms. So we've created a new search control that apps can actually have on their main UI surface. It makes search very easy to find, obviously. Also lets you control the scope of the search, lets you control the presentation of the results themselves. Apps can, of course, still push content into the system indexer so that all of their information inside the apps actually shows up in system-wide search. And of course, with that, the rich search control actually supports things like the multi-language IME and things like that, so you can actually do multi-language search and all the richness that you would expect from the built-in controls in Windows. One of the new things in the Windows Store in 8.1 is support for consumables. So these are purchases that one of your customers can make over and over again. And it's a great way to monetize content. We've made updates automatic. So you as a developer, when you make bug fixes to your app, or maybe you add functionality or add new features or something like that, those will actually get pushed down automatically to people who've purchased or downloaded your app before. One of the things you're going to really love about the store in 8.1 is actually just the UI itself has changed quite a bit, so that we have a lot more surface area now to actually recommend apps and show you new apps, and it makes apps a lot more discoverable than they were in the store in Windows 8. We've made a bunch of improvements actually to the app model itself, so that, for example, things like multi-language resources can actually be installed on demand from the store instead of getting pushed down with the app from the store, so that it reduces the size of the package. One of the other things that's great is we also increased the maximum size of an app package so that for things like games in particular, where there's a lot of really rich content, you've got all the space to actually be able to deliver that content with the app. For web developers, we've made some great improvements to IE in Windows 8.1. So, for example, the F12 developer tools that are built into the app are much richer than they were before, and they give you much better control over debugging and profiling. One of the important things about 8.1 is that it's actually a free update, and because it's actually distributed through the store, it'll be really, really easy for customers to actually get it. So we do expect it to be distributed very, very broadly. Between all the platform improvements, the improvements to the store, the improvements to the user model, 8.1 is going to be a great update for Windows 8.